Hi, I'm Jerry Regula, product engineer with McWane Ductile. We are at the McWane Ductile Universal Test Facility to demonstrate the do's and don'ts of installing the McWane Ductile SureStop 350 gasket. These seven easy steps are provided on our tip sheet, which is available at the McWane Ductile website under the Learning Center tab. Step number one, you want to remove any dirt, debris, ensure that the gasket groove is as clean as possible before you insert the gasket. Your wire brush, make sure it's nice and clean. You can take a regular brush and brush out any excess water and again, debris. Take a rag, wipe out any excess water, make sure that's all out. Step number two is to make sure any dirt or debris, mud, etc., remove anything that may interfere with the installation of the spigot. You want to go all the way back to the home line. Last step, take a rag. Make sure your bell and your spigot are absolutely clean. The next step is to install the gasket. Remember, in cold weather states, you want to make sure that the gaskets are kept clean and above 40 degrees Fahrenheit prior to installation. So we want to take a rag and make sure the gasket is nice and clean, just like we did with our bell and spigot. When we go to install the gasket, we want to make sure that the bulb goes in first and the heel goes in the retainer groove. For large diameter installations, which would be 20 inch and 24 inch, we want to have two loops in the gasket. And it's best to have those loops across from each other. And we want to depress these loops into the bell. Check our seal to make sure that the gasket is below the throat. We have a good set on our gasket. Our next step is to lubricate the gasket and the spigot. Always use lubricant that's supplied by your pipe supplier. You want to coat the gasket with a liberal amount of lubricant. Make sure that you get all the way back on the bulb so our gasket is properly lubricated. The next step is to lubricate the spigot, and you want to coat it all the way back to the home lines. Our next step is to assemble the spigot with the bell. A common error that contractors make is to lay the spigot on the entrance or throat of the bell. When installing restraint gaskets, it's very important to center the spigot inside on the rubber of the gasket. Do not allow the spigot to ride up into the bell. You want to center the spigot with the inside bulb of the gasket. So our next step is to insert the spigot. And again, we want to center the spigot into the gasket. Do not allow the pipe to ride up into the gasket, but center the pipe and the bevel of the spigot into the bulb in the center of the gasket. So in inserting the pipe and the spigot into the bell, we must ensure that this is straight, left and right, up and down. The home lines is a good tool to use. As you can see, the distance from the home line to the bell, home line to the bell, home line to the bell, all the way around the pipe is straight. So we know this pipe is straight with this pipe. We'll go ahead and push the pipe home. So it's important to note that additional force is required to home a joint with a restraint gasket versus a standard SBR Tyton gasket. Now that the joint is properly assembled, at this time, this pipe can be deflected according to the size of the pipe that's installed. So after the joint is installed, you can see the bell face is between the inner and outer home lines, so we know that the joint is where it's supposed to be. The last step is to use a feeler gauge. We can reach in there with our feeler gauge and actually touch the gasket, and you can see we're going in the same depth, and we can check all the way around the joint to ensure we have successfully installed our 24-inch pipe and restraint or sure stop gasket. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to check out the McWane Ductile website and learning tab for additional tips and information. And as always, work hard, work smart, and work safe.